Well, that's a long process, and discernment takes some time. So I guess that's the first thing, is to give yourself some time. There's no rush in this. But one of the first things, of course, is that you pray, all right? You need to open yourself up to God and have Him be a part of that decision. If you're not just simply asking that question in your prayer, what do you want me to do, then you're missing the very first step. One other good piece of advice would be is to get a spiritual director. That's somebody whom you trust. Could be a man or a woman. It doesn't matter, but somebody who you can relate to and talk to, who is your advocate. As vocation directors, that's part of our job as well, to sort of advise you and help you in your discernment. But ultimately, we work for our communities. I work for the Province of Our Lady Consolation, and you need somebody who's working for you, right, that you can talk to, you can pray with. So that's the second thing. And the third thing is kind of what you're doing now. Look around, utilize the internet. It's a great resource. There's lots of religious communities out there for every walk of life. You want to ask yourself, how do I want to live, right? Do I want to live in a large house with lots of people, with few people, by myself? What kind of ministries do I want to do? Do I want to do one thing? Do I want to do lots of different things? What's my prayer life? How do I fit into the church? What gives me joy? Is it being quiet and reflective? Well, then maybe you want to look at more contemplative monastic groups. Do you pray through your work, through activity? Well, maybe you want to look at a more apostolic group that's focused on ministry. Lots of those different questions and things you can talk about with your spiritual director. Some good resources on the internet. Obviously, you found our site. So that's a good one for the Franciscans. Another good resource is Vision Vocation Match. So if you just Google that, that is a site that's many religious communities around the country and in Canada feed into that. And they have the Vocation Match. It's like a dating site for religious communities. So you kind of put your profile in there and we'll match you up with communities that fit where you are. And then you can pick and choose some of those that you look attractive to you. And I would recommend that you do that, that you narrow it down to, you know, 5 or 6, 7 communities. Often when we get those profiles, you know, we get the bottom of it is this person contacted you and 87 other communities. It's too much information. So really take the time to read through some descriptions and choose a few. And then you have to visit. Ultimately, it's where are you going to feel like this is where home is. This is where God is calling you. And you can only know that by having some exposure to that community.